Wahanuzega, a long time ago when I was a young girl, about your age, my family, like many other families, would gather around and sing in front of the fire. They all sang so beautifully. And Mike Noha, my mother had such a special way of singing. I wished I could sing just like her. But every time I opened my mouth, just like you, I'd squeak. Mike Noha tried to help me learn, but I was so embarrassed, I just couldn't. One night, everyone was gathered together, and the singing was so beautiful.
Ayo, ayo, haya, weya, heya, weya, heya.
Then something terrible happened. My mother, always trying to encourage me, turned and said to me, "Honey, why don't you sing a little bit?" I couldn't believe it. She wanted me to sing in front of everybody, all by myself. You can guess what happened.
You squeaked?
It was so embarrassing. Some of my cousins started to giggle. I tried again.
Another squeak?
More kids laughed. My mother tried to comfort me. Instead, I pushed past her. There was a sad look in her eyes as I ran off into the woods, angry and hurt. Before I knew it, I was a long way from home, deep into the forest, lost for sure. Yadwa Santos. The sun was setting. Everyone was saying goodnight. The frogs were croaking. The crickets were chirping. The robin and the sparrow and the hawks were calling to each other. And the wind was whistling through the maple trees. There on a hillside was a family of wolves, howling and singing with each other. I knew I was part of the wolf clan, so maybe I could sing like Tahune, the wolf. I wanted to sing so bad. I tried howling, but it came out all wrong. Oh! They looked at me, and it seemed like they were laughing at me, too. Oh, I felt so sorry for myself.